Good morning. As Ian so eloquently pointed out, innovation is actually key to what we have to do. And innovation can be therefore seen picking up on something that's been structurally ignored, or whatever the case may be. So innovation creep as well as those eureka moments. I'm here really to talk a little bit about the business of sport. Making sport must change its business behaviours to achieve its aspirations. From first experiences to grassroots to youth development, and certainly through high performance. And some of the behaviours that have been exhibited in the past are certainly at cross purposes with those aspirations. Ian talked a little bit about sustainability. I want to talk about sustainability and growth. And also I want to make sure that we understand that this is the sharp end of the stick. Close to 25% of children in Canada now cannot afford organised sport. This is from a G9 country, this is intolerable behaviour. This is because we just don't get it when it comes to the underlying financial model that makes something sustainable and also allows us to grow. Because what is sustainable right now, in the grand scheme of things, may not be so sustainable in the future. We all have a role in this process. Sustainability, opportunity, strong governance, sound decision making, the challenge for us is the sense of urgency which we strangely ignore. It seems that unless it's we're after sex, we're starving, or we're going to kill each other, we don't actually act. But unfortunately, in this case, death of our systems and our children is a real aspect. We need to move from reliance on the public purse. Because, of course, without major public policy changes, we're screwed. So the change of behaviour is necessary, or we will fail. Our behaviours, we talk in glowing terms about not-for-profit. Where in not-for-profit does it tell you that you cannot make a surplus and direct that surplus to mechanisms that you can convert back into the system? Nowhere. And that's not to say that all not-for-profit organisations are poor. At all. But we as a collective need to change our behaviours. Where are your business summits for your sports? Whether it's at your own club level, whether it's at the organisational level, or indeed even at the national level. We need to produce revenue-generating strategies that run ruthlessly, seamlessly behind the actual programmes. We need to make sure that we can subsidise elements that require it. We need professionals who get it and help long-term financial planning. And everyone is responsible for the P&L, the profit and loss. Without that, we are beat. The business of sport is absolutely critical. As we move to the reality, we get into maybe. Right now, looking forward, things seem extremely difficult and challenging. But I assure you, if we move forward, 10 to 20 years, and we're looking back, the right things to do would seem obvious and almost inevitable. We have to take that view. So organise yourselves and others around the business of your sport and like activities, and make sure that we do truly get to sustainability and growth. Thank you.